And welcome back, everyone. My name is Eltamar, and we are going to be continuing our Let's Play of Pillars of Eternity 2. Where we left off last time, we're going to go talk to Luca and go renegotiate a deal, probably with a huge amount of intimidate. Where is Luca? Luca's office. There we go. I went the wrong way. If not, we'll kill everyone. No contracts.
This room's typhus already. Must you crowd it further?
I spoke with Tawanyu outside. You have a claim on his tribe's land.
Back? A lawful claim, I might add. No matter what the native says to the contrary. He showed up with a forged contract, as if I wouldn't know the difference between our paperwork and theirs.
He gestures dismissively out the door.
Tawenu is lucky I only seized the forgery. The Galid is too good for his kind.
There must be some agreeable way to sort out Tawenu's problem.
Your villager friend would do well not to stand between the company and our prize. The company is allowed to solve problems as we see fit. And right now, Tawenu is a problem. Besides, lying is second nature to the Ranga heir and his ignorant cliente.
You know, I can always just sit on the office stoop and tell passers-by how the company conducts itself.
Ack, I see.
Luca glances away, his gaze wandering anywhere but your direction.
The company would appreciate it if you kept our affairs as discreet as possible.
He clears his throat and passes you a pouch of coins.
Now move along. I have larger matters to resolve than the fate of one insignificant island.
Alright, we'll go deal with the other thing. Maybe we can just... Maybe this is the specific thing we were looking for here. Let's go up here.
Ishii, quiet time.
Search for the contract with the Duope tribe. You find the document outlining the Valian Trading Company's legal freedoms over the lands of the Duope tribe. Examination confirms that the Duope island will revert to Valian ownership upon the death of the Ranga. The details are obscured behind legal contrivances. Let's swap the contract. Let's see if I can tamper with the contract? Yeah. Alter the terms of the inheritance so the land will stay with the tribe. Adjust the terms of the contract in the absence of an inheriting son or daughter, ownership of the Duope lands will revert to somebody possessing fragments of the Ranga's soul. The new terms of the contract seem legitimate and well executed enough that no one should be able to question their authenticity. I'm good with that.
I'm listening.
I just want to gain a level, that's all I want. We're 10,000 away, we're so close. Or, yeah, 10,000. Problem solved. Everything is A-okay. We are so good at dealing with problems. We are the best at problems.
Akira, you return. What say, friend?
Tawenu touches his brow in greeting.
Strange smell follows you, I say. I hope you're not unwell.
Why'd I be unwell?
I'm going nowhere, my friend. The clerk and all of his harmful words could not move me.
Wait, do I have to go... Okay, let's go back in. Maybe we missed something. Maybe I should talk with Luca again? Tell him that you should check the contract?
This room's typhus already. Must you crowd it further?
You said Tawenu gave you a forgery. Let's compare it to the real thing.
Merda, if we must.
Luca waves a dismissive hand and steps away to retrieve the document.
This... No, something is amiss here.
Luca scrutinizes the contract with a frown and even pauses to hold it up to the light. Something wrong? Luca shoots you an annoyed glance as he flips through the pages of the contract.
I know a forgery when I see one. This document is a mess.
He slaps the pages with disdain.
And it is my only copy. Merla, the governor will have my stamp for this.
Luca trails off, muttering to himself. Well, it sucks to be you. Just a minor side quest before the end of the game.
Akira, you return. What say, friend?
Forget the smell, your village is safe from the Valian Trading Company.
Akira, I cannot believe! A light after our long sorrow.
His smile broadens and Tawenu slaps your shoulder with encouragement.
Valian makes the work of conquering you people look easy.
Maya clucks her tongue and grins to herself.
Their words are poison, I say, as are yours. My village is modest, but I came prepared. I set aside a few gems for trading. They are yours by right.
This is all? I assume you paid for food, Nekataka. Give me whatever you've left.
Not much. I apologize, but here.
With a shaking hand, he passes you a paltry sum of coins.
You are
sucks.
A friend of the Duape. We do not forget.
20 smiles, rolling his shoulders with the ease of one who stands suddenly taller.
I will tell my people that Ngati's chosen brought hope to the Juana.
He touches his brow with a special reverence for Takehu.
Feel free to keep me out of it, I say.
Takehu glances away, biting the inside of his cheek.
Come closer, Watcher. We should speak.
Why are there so many people?
I was just thinking of a way to help the little tribal that would also screw over the Valian Trading Company. But you beat me to it. You're becoming quite the asset. Not that the company needs help eating itself from the inside.
I'm guessing that you want to be my best friend and that together we can do some real good in the region, is that right?
Sharp. I like that. Once you're coached up and guided in the right direction, I think you'll do very well indeed. If you have any inclination to aid the Juana as a whole, rather than save one pitiful village at a time, you could do worse than tour Imperial Command at the Brass Citadel. Pay us a visit, why don't you?
Okay, we're gonna hop on our boat before anyone else tries to get us to do their bidding and any more crew members threaten to leave. I wonder who we're gonna have to fight. There's no clear end boss to this game so far. That's, I guess, a little bit of a concern. I have no idea what I'm going to be fighting at the end. The Guardian, maybe, is the end boss of the game, technically. But so far, our end boss choices are Aethys or the Guardian. There's literally nobody else. Or possibly, I guess, some of the other captain, or like the other leaders of the other factions. But, I mean, even that, not really. We need to stop here for one sec. We need some medical supply. Where is my medical supplies? There they are. How many are we at? 55, so we need 45. And we have cannonballs. We're full up on those. Alright, good enough. Our garbage boat. I'm really not pleased with our garbage ship. Where am I supposed to go? They said to meet us up here somewhere. Yeah, the game's not locking up anymore. You can clearly see the time just going normally, so... weird. Why are we drinking water? I'm pretty sure I gave my ship ale and stuff, didn't I? I guess we should have bought more ale. Alright, well, we have tons of these things lying around we're never going to use. Give them that mead, and whatever that is. That's rum. Give them the rum first, we'll get a morale up instantly. You can eat a cuttlefish, I don't care. Whatever this is. Yeah, sure. What else do we have lying around? Arrak, sure, drink that too. And then water at the very end if you can't get anything else. Where are we supposed to go? I mean, I think we're pretty much done all the main side quests. Dance with Death. There we go, that'll tell us where to go. Oh, we just have to go to Dunnage with the ship. Oh, okay. I thought it said we had to meet him here for some reason. Let's go sailing back across the sea. Why not? Let's listen to the lovely chanting slash singing of our crew. We're about halfway there. Thinking we should be pretty close. What's our morale? Oh, we're working with injuries still. Wait, whoa. Okay, there we go. When we stop, we should be out of injuries, which is good. You find two of your crew members playing a game in the hold. What game? You're examining cargo in the hold when the sound of whispers and muted laughter draws you deeper into the darkness. You carefully round a stack of crates to find Elda and Baltia engaged in a round of Orland's Head. Elda salutes, "Hello, Captain. We're putting down a copper on Orland's Head if you're looking to join for a round." It's Orland's Head. You carve an Orland into the mast like so. Baltia grins, gesturing at a crudely rendered figure with comically large ears and a rabbit nose. Then you throw daggers at it. Each part is worth a different number of points, on account of it bearing being some harder to hit than the others. The nose, for example, is worth a lot of points. Sure, I'll play around. Fantastic, Baltia takes a step back. I'll set this one out. I don't like losing coin. Alda chuckles, produces his dagger, and spends an unnecessary length of time before aiming the shot, loosing it at the Orland. The dagger sinks into the Orland's nose, and Baltia chuckles. That's 10 points for Alda, Captain. Can you top that? I'll try and land one in the nose. We got the eye, 5 points. He got the mouth, 5 points. 2 points for us, 1 point for him. 7 points. Oh, I lost 500 bucks. They went back to duty after that, and we gained 5 morale. Good, that was good. At least we got some morale out of it. I was worried that was going to lead to a thing with Seraphin, but no, it seems to be just fine. Dunnage! There goes all of our medicine we just bought, literally. We must have had some serious injuries. There we go. Let's go to Balefire Beacon and take the ship. If he tries to take the ship from us, we'll kill him, and then we'll join the Rautai, I guess. I mean, there's going to be one faction that wants us more than others, and if they keep betraying us, we'll go by ourselves.
Gazeta?
He nods. I am the captain of the Floating Hangman.
Magnificently done, Gazeta. Nothing, not even a god, can stop our ascent to greatness.
We forgot something.
The Principi are ready to sail for Ekaizo.
Okay, good.
I bid you to join with my fleet near Andres Mortar.
He offers you a stiff bow in parting. And that is level 20. We are max level. Cool. Quickly level up to level 20. What do we want for our very last ability? Oh, tough call. We got the flames. We could get Stoic Steel, although we don't move too much anyways. Spell resistance might be good. Healing might also be good. Or resistant to intellect afflictions might be really, really good. Yeah, we're gonna grab that. I don't want to be mind controlled. Saber, I guess. How are we looking for time? Why did my thing move? Why can't I see how much time we have left? 1 second. Damn it. Stupid Steam is blinking. There we go. Alright, 13 minutes. Good. That's better. What do we want for our last fighter ability? We can get Unrelenting. Chopping Wood? No. Yeah, let's take that. That sounds good. We are grabbing Take the Hit. He interposes himself between attacks and nearby allies. The final damage of any attack against nearby allies cut in half, with the fighter taking the other half as raw damage. Give him... I don't know. Maces, I guess? Daggers? I don't think we really need any of these. We'll grab flails, because why not? And, of course, Jyoti. We can get Hand of Breath, which reduces strength of all spells and abilities, so it lowers power levels from enemies. Megrin's Might. Pillars of Flame cleanse enemies, which is just enemies. deals damage and lowers... Actually, yeah, it's pretty nice. Does it hit everybody? It does. Revenge of Skane causes blind to anyone inside or who moves into the area, which could be good or bad. We'll grab that one, sure. And we'll take, I don't know, clubs, mazes, sure. She's not going to change her weapon now. She's been using her sickle the whole game, and it's pretty good. I leveled it up nicely. Mechanics and bluff. One ability for one class. We can get accurate power. No. Check ranger. Maybe there's something there I want. Yeah, we'll get that. We're taking thorny roots. It causes the roots to cause immobilize to do damage as well. Because why not? She doesn't really need any new weapons, so I'll just give her, I don't know, warbow. Not that it matters at this point of the game, but whatever. Next and last character, Takehu. Last chanting ability we can give him. Well, power level, straight up. That's what we're gonna do, because that's amazing. That ability is really good. Good enough. Alright, we're done. Streets of Dunnage. We're gonna quickly stop into Nekataka. And actually, you know what I'm going to do? We're going to end this video early. No, first we're going to talk about, then I'll end the video early. We're going to go deliver that sword like we said we were going to the Death Knight, Death Guard, whatever. And then we will, then I'll end it whatever time that adds at. And then I'm going to go around to the towns, gather up what I can for the items I want to buy, upgrade them as required. And then we'll finally head in to the end of the game, I believe. Yeah, that is our grand plan. Gonna go well, I think. We'll also buy more ale when we're in here as well. We're gonna go buy all the magical items we can get that I believe we'll need, or at least want. We're probably gonna go sabers on our main character, even though that axe is really, really nice and it's legendary. I think we can get better damage with two sabers. Am I going the wrong way? We're being crazy. Going the wrong direction. You must, we need to go to this Hanging Sepulchres. Go turn in the sword. Do some equipping of people. Probably go win the game. That's sort of the strategy we're going to go with. We said we would bring back the sword, and we shall. Although maybe we can keep it. I wonder if it's any good. Maybe we can kill Ysir the Baratheon.
Have fares, brother.
Well, hard to complain. All that beauty and fresh air out there. You should come outside with us sometime. It'd do you some good.
The fires flare hotter in the Death Guard's eyes.
Oh, right. That's my fault there. Shouldn't have brought it up.
Again, now. Speak.
I've come to return your sacred charge.
It takes a brave soul to relinquish such a fair and deadly weapon. I'm ready to resume warding it, then.
He outstretches a cadaverous arm.
If you're ready to relinquish it.
It's a good sword and all, but maybe it's best not to owe Barath any more favors.
I'm inclined to go with Adair's advice.
I warn ye. Don't think you can keep both the weapon and your life. Not forever.
It's yours to guard once more.
Barath be thanked.
Okay, bye.
Leave it to me.
Have fares, brother.
We gave him the sword back. We don't need it anymore, and it wasn't like it was an equipable item anyways. That's the wrong way. So, we are officially done with all of the quests that I have available, I think.
And then you vomited right in my face.
Sorry. So, for now, we'll leave it there. In the next video, we're gonna head towards, I guess, probably the last part of the game. For now, at least until the DLC comes out. Like always, if you have any suggestions or comments, please leave them below. Otherwise, I will see you all next time. Have yourselves a wonderful night, and take care.